So this session we are going to look into PBR, that is a policy based routing. Okay, what is policy based routing and how does it works? That's what we are going to look into in this session. Okay, first of all, what is PBR? What is policy based routing? You can see the name policy based routing, which means in the routing process it works. That is, it mainly focuses on routing and it gives you the information and or it manipulates the traffic based on the policy that the user creates. You can say if you want to reach a particular destination via one route, that is the default routing table will create a set of informations, but the policy based route will help you to overrule the default routing table in order to reach a particular destination. You can see it here as it does routing based on the policy that the user creates. What does it do? It overwrites a normal IP routing. So these two are the key informations that has to keep in mind. The next thing is it will be applied only to the incoming traffic by default. It will not be given to the locally originated traffic. Locally originated traffic means the information that is being originated within the same router. It will not have an impact by default, but if you want, we can do that. So let me have a brief discussion about this. Okay, so this is the topology that I'm going to explain for this PBR, that is a policy based route. Let's consider this topology. We are having a 5 routers and let's see, we have a 2 loopback interfaces of R5. So what I'm going to explain here is we are going to reach from R1 to R5 loopback 0 interface, that is 5.5.5.5. okay, so this is what we are going to look into. Let's consider we are running one of the routing protocols and by default it chooses the path R1 to R2, chooses the path, okay, R1 to R2, and then from R2 to R3, and then from R3 to R5, okay, in order to reach this destination 5.5.5.5. not only for 5.5, even for 55, or if you have any other loopback interfaces or any other networks, whatever it be, it chooses this interface. It chooses the R3 router to reach a particular destination of R5. Okay, so suppose if we want to reach this information 5.5.5.5/32. okay, so this is the information 5.5.5.5/32. we need to reach only this particular destination via R4. If you want to reach for only 5.5.5.5 via R4, if this is our case, if this is our target we need to achieve, then what we need to do is we need to configure policy based route. That's one of the simplest thing over here. Just go into the R2 router and you can mention with any source. You can mention, if you want, you can choose this as a source, or you can choose any, that is whatever be the traffic that has been coming from R1. We can mention from this interface, that can be coming from this interface, that's what I'm mentioning as R1. What are the traffic that has been coming from R1, okay, traffic that is coming from R1 with a destination of 5.5.5.5, that is with a destination of 5.5.5.5, will be moved to this interface, that is towards R4, with a destination of 5.5.5.5, whatever the traffic that has been coming will be forwarded to R4. Okay, other than that, whatever the traffic that has been coming will be processed as per the normal routing protocol does. So what happens is that if you are trying to reach this destination 5.55.55.55.55, the traffic now will go from R1 to R2, R2 to R3, and R3 to R5 to reach 55. So to reach 55, But if you want to reach 5.5.5.5, the traffic will be given from R1 to R2. It will be moved from R1 to R2. Okay, so I will just make a clear note of here. Okay, so suppose if you want to reach a traffic for, let's consider 55 first. Okay, traffic in order to reach 55.55.55.55, customer over here, he's trying to reach. The traffic will move from R1 to R2, and from by default chooses what are the routing table that it does. It will be choosing to R3, and from R3 to R5. So this is what in order to reach 55. But suppose if you want to reach 5.5.5.5, now we have done a policy based route in R2. So what are the traffic that wants to reach 5.5.5.5 will be moved to R4. This is what we have done in the R2. Let's consider. Okay. So what it does is, from R1 it will be reached to R2. R2 checks, is there any policy based routing? It sees, and it sees with a destination of 5.5.5. It sees a destination that has a 5.5.5.5. So if it sees this destination, it has to forward a traffic to R4. So automatically it forwards the traffic to R4, since it sees the particular destination. If we have mentioned any source, it has to match all the criterias. Okay. So then from R4, it will, based on the routing table, it moves the process in order to reach the particular destination. So this is how the PBR works. Okay. By default, it can be given only to the incoming traffic. That is, if any traffic that is coming from R1 or whatever be the router with the particular source or a destination that we have mentioned, it can do policy based route. But it cannot do a policy based route for its own information. Let's consider in R2, if you are having a loopback IP of 2.2.2.2, let's consider you are having a loopback IP of 2.2.2.2. Okay. So this is what your R2 indicates. You are having a loopback IP of 2.2.2.2. You are trying to reach the particular destination of 5.5.5.5. Now in R2, you have mentioned the policy based route. With any source, whatever be the source that has been coming, it needs to reach a particular destination, 5.5.5.5. You need to forward a traffic to R4. So this is what you mentioned in the policy based route. Okay. But it will not do the policy based routing by default. Why it will not do means, by default, it will not accept the locally originated informations. By default, it will not accept the locally originated informations to do the policy based routing. Locally originated information means, we can say it simply as the IP address that is being configured, the interface IP address that is being configured in the router, or referred to as locally originated informations. Okay, so this is what policy based routing by default does. But if you want to do even the PBR, that is even the policy based routing for the locally originated routes, we can do this. For that, we need to say the router also consider our locally originated informations for doing the PBR process. If we mention to the router, then the router will consider that also. So this is what policy based routing by default does. Okay, so this is what a PBR is about. So if you look at a configuration part, how we need to do means, this is our configuration part. Okay, so first thing, we need to check whether the concerned destination is reachable. We need to make sure whether the destination is reachable. This is the first thing that we need to do. Okay, so the next thing is about ACL, access control list. This is our second thing that we need to check. So access list, we need to create access list. That is, with this particular source, If a traffic is coming with this source, in order to reach a particular destination, we need to create an access list. With this particular source to particular destination, we are creating an access list. Second thing. Next is, we are going to configure a route map, create a route map mentioning this ACL. What are the ACL that we have created with a particular source to destination? The next thing we need to create in the route map is that next hop. If a traffic is coming from with this source and in order to reach a particular destination, move the traffic to this next hop. So this is what we are mentioning over here. Okay, so this is the thing that we are mentioning here. The next thing is, we have created a route map with all our necessary informations. Okay, the next thing what we can do is, we need to configure it on the interface. Here in our scenario, we need to configure in this interface. The reason why we are configuring here is, the traffic, what will be the traffic that has been coming from R1 will need to reach here, and then only it will move beyond this interfaces. So if we configure to this interface, it will check the information and process accordingly. So we need to configure the policy based routing at the incoming interfaces. Okay, so we need to configure on the interface mainly to be as inbound. We need to configure this as a inbound. Next is, this is what we will do for default configuration. Suppose if by default it will not check its locally originated information for policy based routing. Suppose if you want to check for locally originated informations also, okay, suppose if you want to check it for locally originated information also, then you need to enable, also consider the local policy. We need to enable the local policy. This is not the command, it's not a command to configure it. I'm just mentioning as, we need to enable the local policy. Local policy also should be enabled, which indicates also consider my locally originated informations while checking your policy based route. Okay, so this is what a policy based route is about. You need to configure in this way. So let me give you one other example over here where it might be used in real time experience. Why we need PBR? I have already seen, I have already said you regarding this. Suppose if you are having 10 servers, sorry, not 10, if you are having 200 servers, let's consider we are having 200 or 100 servers, n number of servers, let's consider we are having 200 servers over here, and among the 200 servers you are having two servers which are high priority servers, or you can say to be as a two servers which are maintained for the higher valuer customer or high priority customer or in high class customers. For them, you are maintaining a two servers which are very high valuable links. Okay, then the traffic from R1 will be moved to R2 and it will be processed accordingly. Here, let's consider you are having a 100 gig link. 100 gig, okay. This is a 100 gig link and here it is just a 10 gig link. You are having here is just a 10 gig link, okay. By default, the traffic, all the traffic will be moving, okay, all the traffic will be moving via R3 to reach destination. So this is what the next thing is, okay. By default, all the traffic will be moving via R3. The next thing we need to check is, for the high priority customer, if we give the same link, it will be splitted at an average of 512 kbps. It will be splitted at an average of 512 kbps per server. Even the high value customers will get only this much of average bandwidth. Okay, so it might even cause a congestion, or there may be some loss of data, whatever it be. If such a case is there, you can enable a PBR for those two particular servers. You can enable PBR for those particular servers in R2 to move the information via R4 to reach those servers. If that is the case, those two servers will be load balanced the traffic with more or less 5 gig. Since it is a 10 gig cable, it will be given a higher bandwidth of 5 gig of connectivity. There will be no loss of data and it will be high end. There will be a speed. There will be no issues in resolving with the customers, in dealing with the customers. Okay, so this is one of the examples where the policy based route can be used. Okay, so this is what a policy based route is about. I hope you understand this session about policy based route. Regarding configuration, we will look into the next session about how to configure policy based route and what are the things can be done. That's it. If you have any queries or questions or doubts regarding policy based routing, just give a comment. Thanks for watching. Until next time.